was doing a thing not long ago for HBO, and they were asking, it was more serious questions. And one of them, they said, what's your earliest recollection in life? And I thought about it, and I said, well, I remember being about 3, and I'm standing on the front seat of the car with my dad, and every time he would turn the corner, I would make the sound of tires squealing. My dad would go, quit squealing my tires. And all of a sudden, it dawned on me, what was I doing standing on the front seat of the car? See, back in those days, kids weren't too good to go through the windshield with the rest of the family. When my kids were 3, I couldn't back out of the driveway unless they were in a car seat with a shoulder strap and a safety fit. Think back, I can vividly recall riding all the way to Florida laying in the back window of the car. People behind us going, Harold, is that one of those bobbing dogs? That's a skinny kid with a big head. Boy, what a big head. My dad slammed on the brakes. You went and bounced around the car like a pinball game. I remember as a child, my mom would leave me, my brother, and my sister in the car while she ran into the grocery store. If you did that to a poodle now, they would fry you on the 6 o'clock news. And I tell you something else, now that I'm grown and have kids of my own, I understand why my mother didn't want to take 3 youngins in the grocery store. I would rather take a beating with a brick stick than take kids in the grocery store. Because as soon as those doors slide open, those kids start begging like homeless people at Christmas time. Somebody with little kids, help me out here. The worst aisle to take kids down in the grocery store is the cereal aisle. Oh, I hate the cereal aisle. You know why? Because little kids buy cereal the same way grown men buy lingerie. They will buy stuff they care nothing about just to get the prize that's inside. And you forget about the cereal aisle. You know, you got them in the store and you're just trying to keep them from putting stuff in the cart. And you turn the corner and there it is. And they're like, you got to buy the Fruity Foster Pebbles. You got to buy the Fruity Foster Pebbles. Oh, please. Oh, please. Please buy the Fruity Foster Pebbles. Please, please, please. We are not buying that. We bought it before. You guys didn't even eat it. It went stale. We had to throw it away.
We'll eat it today. We'll eat it. We'll eat it in the car on the way home. I promise. I swear. I promise. I swear.
I said, I'm not buying it. Put it back.
You gotta buy it. You gotta buy it. You gotta buy it.
That is the point. When I very calmly walk up to the child and I say, where are your parents? Everything has changed. Even their toys have changed. I notice with my kids now, every toy they get's got little tags in it showing you somebody has inspected it to make sure there's no possible way a child could hurt themselves playing with that toy. I remember being 9 years old, my parents bought me a wood-burning kit. Hey, what could possibly go wrong with a toy like that? A sharp metal stick that heated up to 5,000 degrees. And I'll tell you something, our dogs and cats didn't have a little tag around their neck, but everybody in the neighborhood knew who they belonged to. Yeah, the Circle F brand, that's Foxworthy cat right there. You remember the wood-burning kits, remember those things? The cord on it was about that long. So you're always guaranteed to be in right next to the drapes while you played with it. Thinking some of those toys. Did anybody else have the swing set? My parents were too lazy to actually pour the concrete in the ground. We had the swing set. Every time you swung above this high, the front legs would go. There were stunt men that would not swing on our swing set. What were they thinking, some of those toys? Lawn darts. 12-pound darts. You could kill an elk with a lawn dart. And there were no directions. They just came in a box of 8. We used to pull them out of the box, throw them straight up in the air. You catch one of those with your head, you're getting coloring books for Christmas for the rest of your life.